All right, this handsome fella is a 1949 Underwood Champion. It's actually a finger light. It doesn't say finger light on it, but it's one of the earliest models. It's the first year production of the finger light. So it has this beautiful exterior. It looks really nice. This is the original color. It's like this pewter gray, and it's a matte and a kind of like a texture to it, and then the burgundy logo plate and a burgundy space bar and then handles. So it's a very handsome machine. It's going to look wonderful in your office or in your little writing space, whatever you want to call it, writing nook. Anyway, let's take a look at it. So this one, to set the margins, you can see the where it identifies the margins here, but the tab itself is in the back, so you just press it in and then drag it to where you want it. Here is your paper guide. On the right side, your carriage release is this top lever, and you press down on it, releases the carriage. Okay. This one releases the tension on the paper by it pulls back this metal bar down here, and so by releasing that tension, you can adjust your paper. On the left side, you have also the carriage release, and then I believe this is either the carriage lock or it's for, I think that's, I'm not sure. I am going to defer on that one because it's not what I thought it was. So, I don't know what that is. All right, let's open this up. Inside, you're going to see the spools, and it takes a black red ribbon combo. This is the standard universal ribbon. It's a 2-inch spool. These are pretty easy to find. We always carry them on our website and our Facebook page, and on our Etsy shop. So you can find the links to those in the description below. Right here, this determines, you just set this to wherever you prefer, but it determines how hard these tight bars are going to strike your paper. Okay, let's close this up. And I'm going to show you how to reverse the direction of your spool, because when you get to the end of your ribbon, it doesn't mean you need to change spools. It just means you need to reverse the direction. And you do that right here, and you just flip it back and forth. Okay. Also, if your ribbon needs to be tightened up a bit, you just twist it, and that can tighten the ribbon up, and it also kind of moves if you want to move it around. Okay. Let's take a look. Okay, tabs. This is where you tab. You set it here, clear it here, backspace, margin release. Because when you get to your margin, the carriage is going to stop. You hit margin release, and then you can keep going. All right, let's put some paper in and do a little bit of typing. Okay, so I have it just a little bit crooked, so I'm going to straighten that out. Oops. Probably should have just left it alone. There we go. All right, there's no number one on this, as is pretty common on vintage typewriters, so you use your lowercase L. And this is a 1949. Underwood Champion. And it's also called a finger flight. It's one of the early models. All right, let's go ahead and test out all the keys. Let's try this again. So that T is sticking a little bit. I will work on that. So when you do have sticky keys, and by the time this ships out, it won't be sticking, you can use a little bit of mineral spirits to rub it in there. And then if you have like a spray compressor or a can of air, just kind of spray out any thing that might have loosened up. So just before I did this typing demo, I had cleaned all the keys and they were working, but I probably loosened up a bunch of stuff because it was a really deep clean. And I just need to go back and kind of probably blow out anything that got loose. Okay, let's try the red. That was user error for sure there. Okay. I am just got butterfingers today. Let's go ahead and do quick brown box again. So you can see it's, for the most part, it works great. It's just intermittently that tea sticks. So by the time it ships out, we'll have that taken care of for you. But that does happen on some of these older machines, and keeping mineral spirits and Q-tips handy is always good for that, because years and years of just grime build up in the parts. And since we don't restore and refurbish, which means we don't take the parts apart and soak them, we just brush them with a soaking solution. Since we don't take the parts apart, then sometimes keys will stick after some use. But we will go ahead and clean these keys again so they will be working for you. If you have any questions, let us know. I am going to put a photo of this. You can see how it types up on the website. And thanks so much for watching. You all have a great day.